small introduction. I guess you all wish to know more about me apart from the introduction that just happened. How many of you wish to know me? Okay, even I wish to know about myself. Okay, awesome. Okay, because every time I evolve, I was never the same the previous day. You need to evolve yourself. I'm not a Gajini. I do remember what happens the previous day, but I evolve a lot. That's what communication happens. That's why emotions keep changing into better communication. I can't be like this when I'm at home. I can't be jumping like this. People go crazy. But if I'm in the webinar, I definitely need to pull up my socks, wear a nice blazer, give a touch up, and here I go. I'm for the session. Okay, so I'm super happy, but I want you all also to feel the happiness and give a proper introduction. We have something for you. Would you love to dance? No, you don't want to dance? You're going to dance right at your own comfort. You don't need to move. You just have to use your hands and your emotions. Is that clear? Okay, so here I go. Just focus. So we are going to sing. We are going to act whatever the phrases are. Okay? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes, of course.
Everyone in one chorus. Yes. Are you ready?
Yes.
Great, awesome. So let's do this.
Let's do some clapping, stamping, and shouting as we sing If You're Happy. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your feet. If you're happy and you know it, jump hooray! If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray! If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray! If you're happy and you know it, do all three. If you're happy and you know it, do all three. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, do all three.
Awesome. Isn't that? Everyone, do you feel energized now?
Yes.
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 Okay. So now that we're all happy and energized, let us put it this way. You're going to introduce your names, where are you from, what do you do, but with saying, if you're happy and you know it, say hello. Hello everyone, my name is Sudhamai, I'm your communication coach and I'm your facilitator for today's meet. I'm going to give you how to make your webinars, classrooms, your teleconferences through online more interactive, engaging and proactive. So this is what my introduction is. So I'm going to give the same to Sonali. Introduce yourself, but with the statement, if you're happy and you know it, say hello. Yes, start with that. Your voice.
If you're happy, say hello. Good evening, all of you. My name is Sonali Pathare. I belong to Thane. I'm a special educator and right now it's working from home, online, everything.
Okay, great, wonderful. Good knowing you, Sonali. Next, Anjali, introduce yourself, but with the statement.
Good evening, if you are happy.
And you know
it. Then you say hello. Myself, okay. Anjali Chauhan. I'm a teacher in Wangni, Taluk Ambarnath. District Thane.
Awesome. Good to know you, Anjali.
Currently, I am teaching my sessions on Zoom and watching the webinar.
Good, good, good. Wonderful. Asha, over to you.
Hello, good evening, everybody. If you're happy and you know, say hello. If you're happy and you know, say hello. If you're happy and you really want to show, and feel happy and you know, say hello. I'm Asha Negi from Uttarakhand. I'm a teacher in CBSE Affiliated School. And I've joined this webinar because I want to make my classrooms more interactive.
Awesome.
I want to learn a lot from you.
Oh, great. Wonderful. We are having great time over here. Thanks for the introduction. Here goes to Soma. Introduce yourself.
Hello. Hi. If you're happy and you know, clap your hands. Hello. This is Soma Sengupta. I'm from Thane and I take up English for classes 11th and 12th.
Okay.
I'm happy to be here. Thank you so much.
Same here. Over to Panna.
If you're happy and you know it, say hello. I'm Panna from Surat. And I too take 11th, 12th English and working as a vice principal in one of the CBSE schools.
Wow. Good to know, Panna. Good to know. And over to Anita. Anita? Yes.
Hi, Viola. Happy beings. Good evening to all. I would like to introduce myself. I am Anita, based in Mumbai.
So Anita, you will be eliminated. Sorry, that's an elimination. You need to sing the song.
Oh, I am happy and...
That's fine.
I am happy and I know that all are happy. And I am a teacher. I'm a linguist. I speak different languages. I speak Thai, I speak Italian, and I speak Mandarin. Okay. I'm a trainer for Mandarin Chinese. I teach people Mandarin. Okay. I teach Thai and I teach Italian. So, buonasera tutte persone. This is Italian. Good evening to all.
Okay.
So, good to know all of you here. I'm very happy to know everybody and good to associate with you, Sudha. It's really wonderful to meet
Thank
all
you.
Of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anita. Yogesh, can you please come on the video, please? Or if you're comfortable audio, you can go ahead. Okay. How about Gopal? If you can come on, can you introduce yourself? Pawan, Priyanka? Okay. Priyanka, yes.
Hi. If you're happy and you know, say hello. Hello, everyone. I am Priyanka Khimasya. I am from Navi Mumbai and I am Navi Mumbai Vashi. I am taking maths for grade 7th, 8th, and 9th for ICSE board.
Wow. Good to know you, Priyanka. Hope you will have a great learning today evening.
Surely.
Right? Yes. Gopal and Pawan, I still have two people who are still not on video. Well, shall I wait or shall I go ahead? Pawan. Yes, Pawan.
Yeah. I am happy and you say hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello, everyone. I belong to Mira Road, Mumbai as well. And basically, I'm a professor who teaches the economics and financial market subjects to the students of MBA.
Okay.
But currently looking out or pursuing for some other institute as such. Thank you very much.
Beautiful. Wonderful knowing you, Pawan. We have Gopal and Yogesh. I hope they'll be joining us. If not, we are going to the next question to you all. What is a webinar? Please text in the comment section. There's a text over there. You can text it in the chat box. What is a webinar? What do you know about it? Yes. Come on. Text in the chat box. What is a webinar? Okay, wow, that's Soma. Seminar on the website. More. E-version of seminar. Okay, I get that. And seminar take on web is a webinar. Sounds good. Okay. What more? Come on. That's it. Okay. Okay, I have three responses. Yes, Priyanka says yes, same. Okay, she doesn't want to expand or elaborate her answer. She just wants to, be in the sight of someone who's already sick. Rajesh, okay, let's see. Okay, so webinar is nothing but like your seminar, but online, your regular training session or any lecture based on the web is called your webinar. This information shared and interactive session is webinar. Oh yes, let's focus on what is interactive. Why should we be interactive? There's few more session on web wherein participations can be more than 1,000. My God. Okay. Source of information through online basis. Yogesh, somewhere you're coming closer. Anyways, I've already revealed the simple and layman language in a layman language. See, I'm a very common person. I only understand layman language. So, well, it's good you have articulated it. But let's put it this way. Any seminar that's conducted online is a webinar with some slides. A deck of slides and some, you know, lots of information shared. Okay, why do you think that webinar should be interactive? Why shouldn't be? It's one way. The speaker speaking and you listening. What's wrong with that? Yes, in the chat box, we be very proactive. You need to. Yes. Why do webinars or your classroom should be interactive? Why shouldn't it be one way? Yes, let me see in the chat box, everyone. Otherwise, it will be boring. Yep, it's boring. Right? Okay. Someone said boring. Priyanka has literally, honestly, she has confessed that webinars are boring. Do you mean that? To clear our doubts and have participation. Yes, Sonali, absolutely. One-way traffic can be safe, but it doesn't allow all to be part of it. So do you feel part of the session now? Are you? Do you feel that? Or are you feel like yes. You're an alien? You're nowhere in the seminar. You're part of the seminar? Okay, yes. I'm glad I could make you come on. Make you interactive so that it can be sharing of ideas with others' perspective. Absolutely. Interactive webinars are the need of the hours. Okay. Now that I got few answers, can I share a story with you? Would you love to listen to a story? Yes. This is a story of my own perception about webinars plus 5 months back. We haven't been into webinars. I guess most of us are not exposed or haven't logged in any of these webinars that's happening before 2019. Have we? This is the new cult. This is the new trend. This is the new normal of 2020. Thanks to the pandemic. I'm talking very optimistically. Of course, inside I really, you know, I wish. Yes. So a webinar is nothing but which is organized on a web is called a webinar, and it has to be interactive. For some of the people have shared beautiful opinions so that their perspectives are being encouraged and everybody can share something out of it. So you're all teaching, you're all into different subjects of teaching. What is the first thing that you miss in your life right now with your profession?
Interaction. Yes.
Interaction. Okay, number one. Asha, what do you miss in your life, in your professional life right now?
Ma'am, physical interaction with the children.
Absolutely. Nail on it. Yes. Anjali, what do you feel that you're missing? Interaction? Your voice? Or you're on mute? Yes. Okay. So now.
Yes, interactive. Otherwise, the student will become passive.
Oh, yes. So, Sonali, what do you miss? Masti with kids? Oh, yeah, Sonali. I understand. One-on-one communication. So, basically, we are all missing face-to-face communication. Isn't that? Yes. Face-to-face communication is the biggest constraint of webinars. That's the reason webinars become boring. And do you know the minimum focus time of the participant out of 40 minutes of a session? How much time can a speaker hold someone's attention? Anyone? 5 minutes? Bas. Ippusa.
Then? Maybe 25
minutes. We can have more and more activities and we can indulge them in more fun way. learning, learning through fun, and okay. we can have more and more time with him.
This is about 40 minutes of session, right?
Yes.
So you are a very pre-planned trainer who is absolutely ready for online classrooms, I guess, because online yes. classrooms involves lots of stress. Yes. You know, after every session, you feel more fatigued than your regular classes because that involves lots of body movements, efforts to hook the audience attention. Hey, I'm talking about audience because I'm more frequent with adult learners and I'm more frequent with giving my seminars online. You can assume this is for your classrooms also, right? Since I work on a blended way, so I work more with ILTS coaching trainers from different training for all over India and outside. I have overseas students and it's even more harder for me because they don't understand. I try to go into their shoes, walk in their shoes, understand where they're coming from. And there are many constraints of organizing classrooms online. Number one is the 3G. Like now most of us are facing, we don't have good net signals. We are not in a stimulated environment. We are in a neutral environment. We are in our house. So there are 100% chances of distractions. Your mobile rings, immediately you can look into, right? So here comes my story, something on these lines. I was super excited when I heard one of my favorite speakers is going to take a webinar. I was literally dreaming that I would be seeing her in front of my eyes, you know, and I was planning to meet her in Malaysia for her seminar. And that couldn't happen due to this pandemic. So everything got seized. And I am watching her webinar. I have landed. I have enrolled, as you all do those formalities of enrollment in your webinars. What do you do in your webinar enrollment? How do you reach the webinar? What are the process? Yes? Anyone?
Anyone? Yes, we do the registrations, ma'am.
Number one is registration. You have a landing page, isn't that?
Yes.
What next? What next? Anjali, what next?
Confirmation message is being received through email and we are being asked to join the WhatsApp group.
Yes. What next? But now,
Zoom
what
link. Zoom link.
If it is on a particular app, app like Zoom or something or WebEx, then you need to download that app and then you have to log in and all.
So there are almost 4 to 5 steps. You register, you do some payment for that, then you get a confirmation, and you followed by a date confirmation. Then you are given a link, then you reach. 50% of registrations happen, but only 20% reach to the actual session. Imagine that happening for your online classes. If your online classes are boring, how do you expect their attendance? Isn't that?
Yes.
Think. 50%. Isn't that? So how can you make your students rush wherever they are? No, it's Asha ma'am's class. No, Anjali ma'am's class. Oh, Soma ma'am's class at 2 p.m. Come on, there's a reminder. The alarm ringing. Sonali is taking a class and the students are like, mama, feed me fast. I have a class to attend. How do you make them do that? You know, the urgency to attend. I had this urgency to attend for my favorite speaker. I dreamed about meeting her in Malaysia, but I couldn't because of the session got canceled due to the pandemic. Now, I met her. That fine day have actually reached. I've landed for her seminar. She was extraordinary using the vocabulary, most beautiful vocabulary she was using. Yes, Panna?
If your webinars are... like creating curiosity. Curiosity is the key thing which can be brought into your webinars and bring back the students because they are always curious to know what is going to happen today now. What is in the session, today's session? What is the new thing what my teacher is going to teach me today?
Absolutely.
That is the most important thing.
So for that, you definitely need a planner, a constructive way of holding someone's
attention. A well-planned seminar session.
Yes, well-planned session is mandatory, my friends. For that, we have something I'm going to give you throughout this session. Then you can also use that. Yes, so here comes the story which I'm in between. Thanks, Panna, for giving me wonderful inputs on the session. How can we make it more interactive? Now, here comes the story. I was actually seeing her. Then within 5 minutes, I started losing interest, not because of the content she's delivering, But the kind of stimulations I was having all around me, if I was in a training session, I could have invested some lakhs to go to Malaysia to attend her session, see that I enjoy to the fullest, learn great. But what happened? Why I lost within 5 minutes of my interest? No, I didn't lose my interest. I was distracted. I was looking, the minute I sat here, I was looking, my phone rang, I was distracted. Then I was like, my kid ran and she said something. I was almost distracted. I was trying pushing myself, but I couldn't hold myself. Then I saw from here that my used bowls are laying, so I had to rush back. And in somewhere in my mind, okay, I'll see with the recorded version. See what happened to the enthusiasm? What happened to that much created hype about that webinar? The speaker was the same energy, but I lost. So this happens often even with any of the trainers, teachers, coaches. So how can we still build up that enthusiasm, that curiosity which Panna ma'am has just mentioned? How can we do that? We can do that through ice breakers. Okay, now I just did one activity. What was that? Review. What was the first thing that I have done? We have worked with colors.
The colors.
Right? And how do you see? Did you see each other? What color did they carry? Did you see? Yes.
Yes.
What did you feel? Seeing each other's colors and objects, what is the first thing that you felt?
Curiosity to know how the other person is feeling.
Right. Even before I say, you have connected to each other. You wanted to see how they are feeling. So this is all about connections. Content may be the king, but connections is the core. So how do you connect to your audience, even in your virtual communication? How do we do that? The next thing which I did was make you all introduce yourself. How did I do that? Yes. So I made you ease up, relax yourself. Probably you've been into some stress or something and you just sat for the session and you're not in that mood. I just brought you into a state of mind. Are you in the state of mind to listen to me now?
Yes.
Yes. So I brought you all into my level of mood. You are absolutely energized the way I am trying to take you.
So DOL is very important.
Yes.
DOL is very important in a session.
Yes, absolutely. You have to, the trainer has to bring the audience to his level or her level, or you have to bring your students to your enthusiasm level. Every day, can we do this? Yes, we can do this through our icebreakers. So what is icebreaker?
It's a sort of energizer.
Okay.
Anything short here? Activity, fun activity.
Fun
to
activity.
Engage the audience.
Okay. Can we do this for anyone with any type of learners?
Yes. Yes.
Icebreakers are?
To grown-ups, we can work out icebreakers. Anything else you want to say about icebreaker? What exactly?
Yeah.
Yes.
Just to draw the attention, energizer to be taken.
Oh, great. Asha, that's the right one. Yes, Panna, are you trying to tell something?
Yes. Ha.
Icebreakers are something where you connect your audience, that means your students, yes, with the topic what you're going to teach. So that is
right. Yes. Absolutely.
That connectivity.
Actually, icebreakers are something that will bond you with the other person. The listener and the speakers are connected.
Okay. You're still not coming close. You're absolutely...
Ma'am, I would like to add in it, your voice modulation with your expression matters a lot.
Absolutely. Wonderful, Sonali. But here we're talking about icebreakers. You're talking something more intricate. I'm talking something externally that you should start. See, you should start with the door entrance, right? You're already into the house.
Like a breakthrough.
Talking about the bedrooms. Yeah, here I'm talking about the entrance. How to enter into people's minds.
A small break from what they are thinking and to, engage the audience to what are we going to speak about.
Absolutely. It's like a breakthrough.
Yes, breakthrough.
Yeah. it's a breakthrough, which like helps students to stop what they are thinking and over that connect with their thoughts, with your thoughts, what you are going to teach them. That means the connection between the topic, what you are going to teach, and the connection to their thoughts, that helps them to think about it. So that,
wow.
I guess, yeah.
Wonderful, Panna.
That connection.
Or can I put it in a layman language, that I say something like you have that awkward silence between you and someone and you just need someone to start a conversation?
Yes.
Absolutely. Is that an icebreaker? Absolutely. Yes.
Is that a conversation breaker? Somebody should break the ice. There's some awkward silence for the first time because you're all strangers to me. Even then, did I break the ice? Did I break the ice?
Yes.
Have I conquered your mind right now? Have I? Are you sure? Did you allow me to sit in your hearts? Did you? Are you on the same wavelength with me? Yes or yes?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So this is what, as a teacher, trainer, coach, or anyone who wants to break, because breakthroughs are important. You need to put across your opinions. How do you do this? You can't barge in. You have to break it with a gentle word, like a good morning itself is a, what do you say? It's a icebreaker. And hello, hi, everyone is again a house icebreaker. Or talking about, hey, I have a very important news to announce. That's an icebreaker. Do you want to listen to a story? That's an icebreaker. Or playing some games is also an icebreaker. To break the ice, the awkward silence, the uneasiness between a participant and to a trainer, you definitely need few tools, something like this. So are you ready for our first icebreaker, everyone? Yes, everyone, are you ready?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Now, as teachers, how could you engage with an icebreaker? So you have wonderful, I've already given you few examples of icebreakers, even asking questions. What is a webinar? That's an icebreaker. I made you all to chat in the chat box or make you speak. I've asked, what is interactive session? I already told a story. You can also share an anecdote. That's an icebreaker. So you are already into the concept. I've already pulled you into the concept. I've already made you welcome into the concept. Clear? So yes. You're already well versed with icebreakers. Now it's up to you. How do you do this? Let's do one activity with an icebreaker. Just give me a second. I will be playing something for you as an icebreaker. We already have one icebreaker as when you're happy and you know it. Yes, that we already have done that, right? Okay, so here comes another one for you. Can you see anything on your screen? One second, I'll share the screen. Yes. Yes. What do you read? Tell me and I forget. Okay. Teach me and I remember. Involve me and I learn. So that's the reason why icebreakers, energizers, role plays are very important exercises for online teaching, for on-site teaching, when you're dealing with your students. Anywhere you need this, not just online. But online is more needed. So I've come up with few icebreakers that we are going to have it right now. Okay. Give me a second. Okay. How many of you teach English?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yeah. Yes, everyone, I guess most of you love to teach English because English is the most beautiful language. Okay, I'm going to share you something. Yes, these are quizzes. You can also use this in your classes to engage their minds. Yes. I'll give you 5 minutes. Everyone, find out the emojis, the meanings of them, and text in the chat box. I'm going to count out of 10. How many can you make it? On a count of 10. I want all the names of the verbs, proverbs that you're watching. They're all very familiar English proverbs that you all know right from your childhood. On count of 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So, how did we do this? Okay. So, this is how you can engage your classroom with certain icebreakers. Morning, you can just post it in your, yes?
Ma'am, yes. Empty vessels make more noise.
Right from 1. I want from 1 to 11 in the sequential order. Not just 3 here, or 2 here. So, this is how you have to define it to your students. Instructions are compulsory. You need to tell them you are going to get 5 minutes of time. In 5 minutes, you need to work faster. Or you can also make your class pair up. Because online, you can't. If there are 2-3 kids together, they can pair up as groups and they can work. You can say Aktish, you can say Anjali, Asha, Sonali, one team. Soma, Priyanka, Pawan, one team. Anita, Panna, Gopal, one team. You can pair them up and you can work within time. So what are the verb proverbs you could find in the emojis? Because kids love emojis. So you can also place certain teams like that to, you know, build up that team, that rushing, that energizing thing for them. So the first one is health is wealth. I got Sonali. Yes, good one. Then you have empty vessels make more noise. So, wonderful participation. Pen is mightier than sword. Whose answer was that?
Priyanka.
Yeah. Priyanka, yes. Good. Next is honesty is the best policy, which is your fourth one. And the fifth is Rome is not built in a, it's like be a Roman in a in the Rome, right? All that glitters is not gold.
Not gold.
Then you have, what is that? Time and tide waits for no one. Yes. Barking dogs never bite. Apple a day keeps a doctor away and unity in strength. That's how you have to build up. You're not prepared for this, that's fine, but you can do this with your students. See how it works. Be more proactive. These tools will be really helpful. I guess this will be very helpful right in your next class, right? So this is one icebreaker that you can try with emojis using proverbs, right? Or idioms, or you can also do certain things like this. I'm sharing it on your screen. Can you all see this? What's wrong? Yes, everyone. Can you see on your screens?
Cow is flying.
Okay, so you need to find out what are the mistakes that you see in a picture. This is for early learners. Maybe class 5, 6, you can engage this. We also have for adult learners. Now, let me find out. Sonali, what is the mistake you find in the picture?
Animal.
Yes. Cow is flying.
Cow is flying. Animal. Yes, Soma, what did animal. You say?
The animal with one boot, whereas yes, the good. Child has.
Okay. Anjali, what did you find?
Socks. Socks is there.
Yes.
Socks is weird, but the horse, I think.
Okay. There's a and, horse.
With the, yeah, with the horns also.
Okay. So, and what's wrong with the girl? Haven't you seen that? Asha?
The cup is also on her head.
Yes, and she's also wearing skates. Right? Mm. Yeah. So these, and the animal. Horse looks like a hybrid, a mix of a cow, a donkey, and a horse.
Horse.
Isn't that? Because the tail looks weird, the ears look weird, the horns look weird, everything looks weird. But this is how you have to make your students or your young learners to find out the mistakes. Why should we do this? What do you understand from this activity?
Ma'am, to keep them activated throughout.
Okay.
And focused.
Deeper from the perspective as a teacher. Think from that level.
Engage them.
Engaged kids.
Okay. Tripti, can you respond on this? If you're watching, if you're with us. Okay. Gopal, Yogesh. Yes. Any other feedbacks on the session on that particular activity, finding mistakes?
Ma'am, concentration, observation of a kid.
Yes.
Absolutely. Nail on. Wonderful, Sonali. Come on, dig deeper. These mind brain teasers will help them to think little more critical, zara hatke, out of the box. Yes. As teachers, it's your responsibility to stimulate their brains to think on a different level, right? So you can also give such quizzes to your students, like finding the mistakes, find the hidden words, or you can also ask them some blurred, or there are six, find the six mistake or wrongs in that picture. These kind of activities will give an critical thinking attitude in your students. Trust me, I do this every other day and I've been successful. Every class of mine, 60 students from all over the world. Imagine it's just me, one teacher out of 60, that too all different minds. Same age level, but different countries. Imagine. So these type of brain teasers will help them to stay on the track. They will be, and I'll be pairing them. Remember, pairing is very important. Team, making them, teaming them is very, very important. You cannot make them think on single thought. Okay. Team, make teams, allow them to think as a team. This will enhance to know each other's names. And Turkmenistan learner can, you know, talk to a guy from Surat. So, the language is different. They're trying to communicate with each other even then, because they want their team to win. The winning thing is very important. They should get some sort of awards and rewards for each task they do. At least clapping for them is also a simplest way of appreciation. Now, let's all clap for us. We have done wonderful so far. Everyone, wonderful so far. And I have one more thing. Yes. To extend your hand. You're sitting absolutely close. I want your hands to extend. Extend your hands like this. Yes. Everyone, spread your hand. Yes. Can you see my hand? As if I'm hanging hoo or something like that. Half hanging hoo, right? So pat yourself. Pat yourself. Pat yourself. Everyone, pat yourself. Yes. Wonderful participation. I can see you're all engaged and you're happily understanding the nuances of icebreakers. I hope I'm clear on this. Yes, right?
Absolutely. Yes.
Absolutely. I could have shown a most toughest one. Now let's see how creatively you can engage your young learners. Can we go to the next icebreaker? If that's fine?
Yes.
Yes. Good. Yes. Let me show you something else. Okay, I don't want to show you this because it's a bit tougher. Let's make it easy. Okay, so I'll show you something on your screens and let me know what all things you see on your screen. Yes, everyone, can you see an illusional picture on your screen? Yes or no? Yes or yes?
Yes.
Yes. So, what are the things do you see in this picture?
Two persons sitting. Okay. One is playing guitar.
Old.
Yes. One is holding something on the head. In the ear also, one woman is able to see.
Yeah.
It is like the gate, door.
Panna ma'am, are you there with us?
Okay. No. There are two men also with a big headgear and they are playing guitar.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Right.
These have got multiple this thing.
Right. Okay.
When we zoom it, we can see something else.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Here comes another one. Please check on your screen. Can you
Without
see another one?
We can see an old man.
Can you see another one?
Yes.
Another yes, picture. Ma'am. I've changed the picture. Can you see that?
Like a lady is reading and also it is it looks like beard.
An old man.
An old man with black dress. Black.
Man.
Seen.
Okay. So, okay. Can I go to the next slide? So you can see an old man as a one, and then you can see a white dressed girl in her long dress. Her hair is white, actually the nose, the nostrils of the man. His eyes, you can see there's a design, there's a garden behind. And there's another old man with black robes, right?
Like Chinese.
Like Harry Potter. The character in Harry Potter, isn't that? So overall, there are two, three people, an old man, a silhouette of an old man, and again, a man with a black robes and a white dressed girl with blonde hair. Okay, with blonde hair. Can I go to the next picture? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So what can you see in your screen? Yes?
A hunter.
Explorer.
Man is trying to catch
an explorer.
Female structure we are able to see here.
Okay, wonderful, Anjali, wonderful finding. There's a female structure. The bowl, the stones have been formed as a female sleeping, laying on
and,
the ground.
And the mouth looks like the fish.
Yeah, okay. There's a fish out.
Oh, wonderful. And this gentleman, he is fishing. He's trying to catch a fish in the river stream. Or maybe a stream or a spring. I don't know. There are a few other characters behind him also. The trunks have transformed into some structures of the tree trunks. Right?
Yes.
Awesome. Good. Wonderful. Wonderful. Before we go to the next one. Okay. So what is your review on this activity?
Person, it forces a person to think and get engaged even if the person doesn't want to.
Okay. Asha?
Just to explore, just to...
It's mind-boggling.
Yes. I'll give you each, a minute to think back. Okay, Anjali, yes.
Each and every student is trying to search something that I want to search and I want to tell. Interaction will be strong.
Yes. Sonali, over to you. What did you find? Yes, imagination with concentration. Sonali, okay, good. Soma, what do you think with this activity? What did you understand?
Okay. Ma'am, allowing students to imagine, to have a broader vision, to think.
Right, right. Priyanka, what do you think?
Ma'am, I said just now.
Okay, it's you. Okay, fine. So Pawan, Yogeshwar sir. Okay, fine. So basically the idea is, yes, imagination with concentration, make them more creative in their thoughts. If you're asking your students to go participate in public speaking and they don't have the creative ideas, how will they participate? So you need to stimulate through such kind of activities. These are called illusional pictures. They stimulate the creative part of your brain, right? If you have more ideas, you can even generate wonderful illusional slides for your students. They can become wonderful essay writers. They can become wonderful book writers in future. They write poems. You need to stimulate their creative thinking. So for creative thinking, the previous one was for critical thinking. This is for creative thinking. So you can use these kind of pictures as icebreakers. Well,
ma'am,
this is...
Can I ask you something?
Yes, Priyanka.
Ma'am, like this is what we can do for English, but for a maths class, what else can we do, you know, because the subject is little different.
Yes, yes. You can give lots of quizzes, you know, or you can simply say, how much is 200 into so and so? Tick, tick one, okay. Tick, tick two. So you can use tables, your tables. You can do icebreakers like with quizzes. You can give a triangle and you can say what are the different shapes, what are the angles you can see. So quizzes you can do with maths. Is this okay? Right. You can also make them think on probabilities, or you can give them analytical thinking. Maths is all about analytical thinking, right? Okay. Or you can make your own formulas. You should find what is missing in that formula. A square plus B square is equal to. So that A square is missing, B square is equal to. You can make these kind of quizzes for them. Priyanka, yes. Are you getting me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So they have to find what is missing in it. Immediately, out of 10, they have to tell what are the things that are missing.
Yes, it's a nice idea. Yes. Yes,
absolutely. Wonderful role plays you can do with maths. It's not just English, even history. You can, if there are any history teachers over here, even with history also you can do it. Like, who is that person who was popularly called as? It's like you can play KBC with them. So this way you can engage your students. Just 5 minutes of engagement. That's it. And you can immediately jump into the class. No wasting of time. Your students will be part of your every class. Trust me, this is going to be great session for you. If you start working on your icebreakers. Let's do an energizer now. Let's think about energizers. Because since now you've been sitting a lot, let's work on your energizers. Okay? So what are energizers? Yes? Energizers.
Maybe be on your toes. To bring back to the mood of the classroom
teaching life. This you should definitely be doing, because once the class is over, the student will be
activated.
Yeah. What sort of thing you do, Asha? What do you do for
them? I'm in English. I take class one students to
keep learning.
For example, I give them code. Actions for code languages. They see. I'll call out a sentence. If it is right, thumbs up. If it is wrong, thumbs down. Okay. So all the grammar rules, I teach them this way only. Now but tell me, if I use of AI or an, I'm teaching. An aeroplane, they'll do this. An lion, they'll do this.
Okay.
So in a sort of game, they use that two things at a time. Action with the mind.
Right. So, Asha is teaching articles using gestures, hand gestures, thumbs up, thumbs down, right? Yes. This is the activity we can do.
So, code language I give them.
Yes. Even Priyanka, you can try something like this. A square plus B square is equal to some mistake you give. If that is a yes, they will do this.
Or tables
yes.
We can give them. 9 twos are 27, they do down.
Yes. Something yes. Like this. So, this gives them a quick thinking.
Only for 5 minutes shall I do this.
Yes. So energizers are basically for to bring you back to their level, you know, to the class environment. We always do this. If you remember, our teacher used to say sit, stand, just to make our body ease up. Now let's do something like this right now. I don't want you to sit and stand and create some casualty with your gadgets. That's fine. You can sit and still do it. Just focus. So here I go. If I say 12 o'clock, you need to use your hands. How do you use 12? This is your 12, and this is your 3, this is your 6, okay? 12, use your hands, everyone. I want everybody to do this. 12, both the hands, if possible, keep your mobile somewhere. Yes, 12, yes, everyone, please come on video. Anita, Pavan, Gopal, Tripti. Okay, awesome, good Priyanka, she's smart. Good. So three. Show us three on your clock. Hands clock. Three. Soma, three. She stuck at 12. All right. So here comes four. How do you do four? Okay. Awesome, Priyanka. Good. You're a wonderful teacher. I get that. Okay. How about 3:30? 3:30. Okay. How about quarterless four. Awesome. Good. Wonderful. Hi, Tripti. Good to see you on your video. Wonderful. Please participate. Yes. So these kind of energizers, Priyanka, even you can do it. You know, in between your session, in between your session, if you feel that they are losing interest, immediately. Hey, everyone, I have something for you. Let's do it. Okay. And you can start.
Yes.
These kind of energizers are very useful for your sessions. So energizers play a very important role. So you can find out, you can design your own energizers, right? So this is about your energizer. Role plays. Now comes role plays. How do you do as a teacher? How do you engage your students with role plays? English, we all know, we have conversational role plays, situational role plays. Priyanka, even you can do this as a maths teacher. Tell them, if I give you this much, and you have to make it this much, tell me what you can do it. Right? So you can design your own role plays. Any ideas with role plays? Everyone, Asha?
Yes, ma'am. While teaching turtle, poetry turtle, I used to tell them, just come on, act like a turtle. Now some naughty children are throwing stones at you. Okay. Now how will you protect yourself? Come on. Okay. Just hide inside your shell.
Okay.
So all these things they do.
Right.
So now you are scared of the children who are playing around. Now, how, as a turtle, how will you act?
Okay.
All these things, we do that.
Okay. So for English teachers, this is something quite regular. We often have to bring up role plays. In communication, role plays are very important to create an awareness that if you are in this situation, what would you do? How would you execute your team spirit? So these kind of things play very important role. That's called role plays. For communication, the last one which I did was, you need to interview a celebrity. Whichever celebrity, come up with the questions. So those people have made me the celebrity. Of course, I am the only one who has to listen. So they will be asking me questions and I will be answering them. This I did it mandatory because they are still at the intermediate level of learning. So they ask questions, and through this, we are basically teaching them vocabulary. What sort of vocabulary we can use for asking questions? It's about celebrity. So I asked them to watch commentary, cricket commentary. I asked them to watch Coffee with Karan. No, you're a celebrity. So Coffee with Karan is the most famous one, popular one. So the kind of questions they got me and I answered them. This is how I did a role play. Then next, for job seekers, I work with interviews, mocks. So this is one role play. And then there's someone who's traveling abroad and he doesn't know how to react to the environment in a airport lounge. So I create a role play for him. And there's one more guy who would love to learn about wood. How could you use wood? So I have given him, you are going to the assistant commissioner of municipality, someone, and you have to appreciate and you have to tell them that what are the things that you would want in the city. So he said, I would want more traffic, more better roads. I would want you to come up with more good infrastructure. So the use of wood will be taught through role plays, right? Difficult words, but easy way to make them understand that they can use them in their day-to-day conversations. Is this clear, everyone? Role plays, you can definitely think more creatively. Creative thinking is must. Don't go with rotting system, the traditional one. Come out of that. Be updated to keep away from getting outdated. Is this clear? This is the call to action for everyone. Be updated with the tools. Like, you can organize your sessions, like webinars, like on Zoom, on Skype, Google Meets, WebEx, Cisco, all these, there are different platforms. Try to explore it. Don't stick to only Zoom. There are many other platforms you can organize your webinars. Just, you need to have that confidence, have some icebreakers in your hand, and you're done for the day. Trust me, you're going to rock.
Okay? Ma'am, I would like to add to it, Google Meet requires more bandwidth as compared to Zoom. So right. At times, you know, we find connectivity issues. So it is better to use Zoom. No doubt the features that are available on Zoom are more as compared to Google Meet. But right. Once you get used to Google Meet, there are ample of tools available right. that are Google Slides, Google right. Sheets, Google Docs, Jamboard, right. and they're very useful for the teaching as well.
Absolutely. Please make a note of Priyanka. Thanks for adding more insights into the session. Wonderful. I have given an idea. She has put more ideas into it. This is how we execute things as teachers, trainers. Come with more thoughts. Brainstorm yourself with such thoughts. And definitely there is silver line to every cloud. Don't get disappointed that we are sitting at home. No face-to-face communication. You are being here for the last 1.5 hours and still you are very active. Haven't you? So this is all about energy. So my dear teachers, keep in mind energy plays a very important role and your voice modulations. Clear, everyone? For that sake, I have one more activity. Trust me, this is the last one. Right? Okay. So are you all bored?
No, ma'am. Not
are you sure? Are you sure?
Yes.
Yes, you're bored?
No.
Thank you. Thanks for that.
It was a good icebreaker too.
So I'm going to show you something. And this is going to be your own. Like you have to look it. And as an English teacher and as a communication, as a presentation coach, I work on people's voice modulations because voice modulations plays a very important role in virtual communication. And your energy is very important. It shouldn't drop till the 1.5 hour of your class. Now you can see something on your screen. Can anybody read that out?
I never said she stole my money.
Yes, you can say this in 7 different ways. Can I try? I can stress. There's something called word stress or sentence stress, where modulations start working if you stress the sentence. I only want the importance on I. So I can say, I never said she stole my money.
She stole my money. I never said.
Yes. So can you read the way emphasize? Anjali, can you put stress on never?
I never said she stole my money.
Okay. Soma, can you stress on said?
I never said she stole my money.
Right. And then Priyanka, can you stress on she?
She stole my money. I never said.
No, no, you don't need to change the whole sentence. You just have to stress on she.
I never said she stole my money.
Yes. Anybody wants to? Asha? Stress on
stole.
Oh, yours are over. Okay. Sonali? Stress on stole.
I never said she stole my money.
Yes. Sonali, can you stress on my?
I never said she stole my money.
Yes, good. And then comes money, of course. I never said she stole my money. So you can also stress like this in your conversations to exaggerate sometimes or to make it important. Make the students, you can, you know, raise your pitch. You can make it fall. If you want some to appreciate someone, you can raise your voice. You can bring them to your attention through your voice. Voice and energy plays very important role even in your live classrooms, right? This is not something new, but you have to master this. Mastering your voice is very important to make it sweet, to make it commandable, to make it authoritative, to make it authenticate. This is very important. Your voice plays a key role. Okay, and there are a few other things that I want to talk about. When you are doing webinar, always see that you are placed or you are in a calm environment. No distractions from anywhere. This is a big turn off to your participants if there are distractions in your surroundings. Number one. Number two, you should always, if possible, wear an earphone, your headphones. I'm not wearing it because I have ear infection, so I'm not wearing it. I'm trying to have some medications for that because this will give a warmer tone to your participants because my voice is leaking and coming through the laptop. But if I wear a headphone, it will reach to your to the attendees in a warmer tone. Number three, always maintain good light. The surroundings should have good ventilation and light for you. Right. And number four, keep your camera. If you're using your mobile, a 3 feet distance, you're sitting at the laptop, at least 2.5 to 3 feet distance. My coach used to make us literally measure with that, tailoring the tape. So this is very important. Even when you're approaching your school, college or any training sessions, the trainer should always maintain a distance of 1 feet to 2 feet. And it's the same with your cameras. Always should be placed just over the, it should just feel the touch of your head. That's how. Otherwise, if you keep it low, your whole body looks way different. We can all see all the anatomy of your body. Now, do you want that to happen? No. Yes. So always keep keep it at 3 feet distance, your and always make eye contact. How do you do this? Look into the camera. Always to look into the camera. If you start looking into the camera, everybody feels connected. Right? If I'm looking into the camera, of course you can also look into the screen, but looking into the camera will give you more connections.
Yes.
Is this clear, everyone? Please maintain these webinar etiquettes. You can't just place it down or sit at a corner somewhere like this. You know, these are the things that most of the people who are using for the first time face lots of casualties with it, because they're using their hand, they're using the holding their mobile. This is not helpful for them. Keep your mobile in a right place, right? So keep these things in mind and you will rock in your webinars like anything. So number one, we dealt with icebreakers and icebreakers. Energizers and quick wind up. Yes.
Introduction, energizer, and role play.
Yes. So three important things I gave you as a tools for webinars: icebreakers, energizers, role plays, followed by your energy, your enthusiastic approach towards your attendees. Every man wants to be heard. I want you to speak and I want to be the listener. You're saying something, I should listen to you. For that sake, you should have good tools. I am audible, I am visible. You should be audible, you should be visible, because it's a mutual communication that's going on. Right, everyone? So number three, body language. How do you use a body language in here? How can we put ourselves in the live environment? We are not in a live environment. Yet your body is moving. Now, one thing that you must have noticed, am I sitting or standing?
Standing.
Why do I do this? Any idea? Why did I do this?
To feel easing up.
Yes.
To feel easing up.
To ease up. Number one. Yes, Sonali, why am I standing?
For movement and to feel energized.
Perfect. Asha, what would you say on this?
Just mentally and physically prepared for your job, which is teaching, and that you can get everybody's attention also, and I can teach also.
Right. This is what a teacher does. She or he never sits. Teacher is the most selfless person, even though they have aching legs, they have aching backs, the health is not good. Even then, the 45 to 90 minutes of session will be on standing without taking a break. Each teacher stands and teaches. Right? So I totally agree with Soma, Sonali, Asha, and Anjali. I didn't ask you anything. Anjali, would you love to add anything? Why am I standing?
Yes. Because while sitting, body language is not seen properly. But when we are standing, at that time, more energy is created.
Can you see me?
Yes.
Am I audible?
And that's why you are totally 100% energetic.
Right. So always maintain a distance of 3, because this is the audibility range and visibility range. If I stand so far, my audibility, maybe because I'm in a very natural environment, my voice, the waves won't flow till the gadget. So always maintain you are 3 feet, right? And yes, the energy level should always be high. And for person like us who have to engage the whole session, you have to be moving, your hands to be moving, your body to be moving. Everything should be moving. Moving. Body language is very important. Eye contact is very important. Voice is very important. So let's do one thing. You're all sitting at your place. I want you all to focus. This is the last activity for you for today's evening session. So focus. Relax yourself. Keep your mobiles at one place, because you're going to do this final activity, which is going to be learning something from it. Yeah. I want all you to sit or stand, that's fine with you, but I want you to enjoy. Now, this session is something called the story of Mr. Right and Mrs. Right. What is the story about?
Mr. Right and Mrs. Right.
Whenever I say right, you should show your hand towards
right.
If I say to left, and your hand should go towards
left.
Yes, good. Good flow. Let's do this. So I'm going to tell you a story. You need to focus and just... No. Yeah. So you just need to do the whole action with your hands. Whenever I say left and right. Is this clear?
Yes.
Okay. Let's do this. Okay. This is a story of Mr. Right and Mrs. Right. One fine day, Mrs. Right was making cookies and she was left with no more flour to bake a cookie. She called her husband, Mr. Right, please come into the kitchen. I am no more left with the flour. Would you love to go to the store and get me flour right now? Yes. So Mr. Right was so fussed up. He said, no, Miss Right, I don't want to go. I want to have sleep right now because I'm left with no more energy. Yes. So, and then Mr. Right had to go and take his car, which is placed at the left side of his garage. He has to drive towards left and to the right, to the left and go to the store, wherein he had to ask the storekeeper, where is the flour ale? And then the storekeeper said, it is quite right side to my table. So the right, Mr. Right walked to the ale, which is in the right side of the storekeeper. And he walked and he searched, but he could find no more leftover flour in the store also. So he has to come out. He walked to the right side of his car, where he has placed it at the left side of his garage. And then he walked and walked till he reached 51st block of the street and the walk went on, but he didn't find any flower or any store in front of his eyes, right in front of his eyes. Yes. So this is the story of Mr. Right and Mrs. Right.
Right.
Well, thank you everyone for actively participating. Now tell me, what is your review on this particular session? Yes, clap for yourself. You must be having hands. No, your hands. Hands play a very important role. As much as like your eyes, your hands should always be moving. And your smile should always be intact. Right? You are beautiful women. Keep the smile intact. Right? Okay, so what is the review of this particular session, particular activity?
Yes,
madam, it was amazing. But because when I was taking the Zoom, only my few activities, when the activities are there, at that time I was giving the gestures and I was showing the activity. But here you tell us that how we should improve our when we are conducting the online classes. It was very helpful, ma'am. Really very thanks to you. And I enjoyed a lot with you. And also I thought so many things from you. And I will definitely improve my teaching or in the Zoom and all that, in the online.
Thank you, Anju.
Thanks,
ma'am. That's the whole plan of this webinar, how to keep the webinar proactive, if I have done justice to it. Thanks on that. Yes, Soma, what's your review on today's session?
Wow, it was mind-blowing and so much energized, means highly activated, especially the last one. You keep your mind activated and focused. What's happening? Where is the word left and right? So you keep yourself engaged.
Right, wonderful. Sonali, over to you.
Most focusing activities. That's what I can say.
Right, wonderful. Good, good. Priyanka.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to give a very honest review. As I did not register for this webinar, seeing the topic, how to, you know, keep your audience interactive during the webinar. So I did not actually register it, but as I had previously registered for one of the sessions of MTT, so I got the link from there and I thought of, chalo, let me check how is it, okay? So I just entered and then you asked, you know, you were waiting for another five minutes and I thought of, nahi, chalo, abhi kya hoga, abhi kantala aega and this, and I was about to move out. But okay. Then I thought, chalo, let us wait for 5 more minutes, abhi itna ruka hai to. And okay. Then I actually... I actually was there for the entire session. So I really enjoyed it. and thank you for a lot of inputs that you gave on maths, English, and overall. It was really a very informative session.
Thank you.
And I really enjoyed it.
Thank you. Sometimes it happens. There are millions of people. There are many hundreds of people who have registered for it, but you only landed and you only are like, chalo, rukte hain, dekhte hain kya hoga. So you're blessed. You need to feel happy that you are.
Yes, yes.
Not just because I'm taking it, sometimes some learnings are for life.
Yes, that is the reason. Learnings are being taken. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Priyanka, on that. Soma, yes, over to you.
Thank you, ma'am, for the enriching session. It was really great. The last one was really...
Thank you.
We need to just the coordination between mind and body.
Yes.
Right. Socho, konsa right, left. That was really very nice.
Yes. Thank you, Asha. Soma, yes. Over to you.
I think this webinar, to make us work with webinars, is fantastic. It really works. It's going to work with all of us.
Absolutely. Because they are cost, low cost, no money involved. You just have to put your energy. My friends, remember, teacher, the whole thing is about energy. Energy transformation is very important. Content with energy is very important. If you have no energy and lots of content, you are a master on something, but you are not able to give the energy, I should say, then that's the whole thing that happened with the lady which I attended webinar. I was distracted, right? I was trying hard. No distractions. I was like a horse without gills, you know, like blinders. But I got distracted. This is quite often happens with everyone. Yes, thank you, everyone. If Panna would love to share anything, I'll be happy to know.
Sorry, I won't be able to because power got cut off and I just...
Right. Tripti, anything else you wish to know?
Hello, yes.
Yes, Yogesh, if you want to share something. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Tripti. Yogesh, yes, over to Radhika, I guess, or Christy.
Yeah, I would like to add one sentence.
Yes.
Looking at your personality and the way you present yourself, I would love to have a session of phonetics with you.
Oh, wonderful. That's good. Let's see how we can associate on that, right? I'm into communication coaching. I do different communication mastery for teachers, trainers. I have different courses. If you want to enhance your vocabulary skills, I'm happy to help you on that. There are a few, of course, commercials associated with it. Let me know if you're interested. We have a batches going on. Like I told you, I'm completely by morning, afternoon, 12 to till 9 o'clock. I'm engaged with different online activities. So, yes, my details. Yeah, I cannot disclose the commercials. It's absolutely first. I need to screen your level of language. I do pre-assessments. Later on, I'll design a course for you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Yogesh, for joining. I guess.